Let's take a closer look at configuring the integration object. There are a few main sections to the object: connection, query parameters, headers, response, and HTTP request response logging. We'll start with the connection section. As you can see, the connected system is selected, and the integration inherits its base URL. You'll use the relative path to specify the resource endpoint and return the correct data. Find this in the API documentation. For example, in an API from the United States National Park Service, there are different endpoints for getting data on activities at parks, alerts, and many more. In this example, I'll use alerts. When I enter the endpoint into the relative path field, the URL preview updates with the relative path appended to the base URL. As a best practice, you should configure the authentication using a connected system rather than in the integration, so you can build multiple integrations off of it and more easily deploy it to higher environments. Some examples of different integrations with the same connected system would be different relative paths or filtering the data differently to create multiple record types. Here, you'll also choose the method to call the API, configure the timeout, and specify the usage. In this case, the method is get because I want to return the data, and the usage is queries data. This is because we want to query and return all of the data to display in the record type. Now, I'll click Test Request to make sure it's working. The data is successfully returned, and a link appears to convert JSON to Appian value. When I click Test again, the data is now structured in a way I can use in Appian. The next section we'll look at is query parameters. These parameters will help you filter the data so you only return what you need. The API's documentation will specify what the name is, and you'll enter the value based on what you need. Let's look at an example using the park alerts. When I test the integration, I get all alerts throughout the United States. But let's say I only want alerts in the state of Virginia. In the API's documentation, for the alerts endpoint, there's a list of parameters that I can use to filter the data. To the integration, I'll add a parameter for state code, and then for the value, enter VA. The documentation tells me how to format the value as a two-character state code. When I click Test again, I only get alerts for this state. You'll also use query parameters for batching, which we'll talk more about in the next lesson. Finally, let's quickly review the last few sections. Headers send additional information about the request to the external system. Valid headers are also specified in the API's documentation. Response gives you the option for the format of the response. Convert JSON to Appian value is selected because I clicked that link earlier. And last is HTTP request response logging. Selecting this box will log the raw requests and responses, which is helpful for when the app goes live and if you need to troubleshoot.